Hello everyone, Matt here. In this video, we learn how to work with forge energy in MCreator. To cover it as much as possible, we'll be creating solar panels, energy-powered fans and batteries. As a bonus, we'll also create a universal energy meter that can measure the capacity of any forge energy-based blocks from pretty much any mod. Now let's get started. Before we create all those goodies, I'd like to introduce you to all the procedure blocks, as well as how you enable energy storage and transfer in the blocks themselves. There is a general agreement in the world of forge energy that blocks should push energy out on their own and receive it passively. Blocks can receive or extract energy on any site, depending on what the block defines. As of right now, MCreator blocks can both receive and extract energy on all sites, which doesn't limit their use, but it's worth keeping in mind. This functionality will very likely be extended in a future version of MCreator. To allow blocks to store energy, you first have to enable Tile Entity and then go to the Energy and Fluid Storage tab, where you can enable the energy storage. You can set its initial energy, which is the energy that is already in the block when it's placed, as well as its maximum capacity, energy receive and extract rates. As for the procedure blocks, the first two allow us to check whether a block at coordinates supports energy extraction or receiving. Then we have the Get Capacity block for getting the max amount of energy stored and Get Energy to get current energy. Test extracting and sending blocks are used to find out how much energy can be sent or received by a block. This can be lower than the specified amount depending on the output rate of the block sending energy, input rate of the receiving block, as well as its maximum capacity. The provided energy is the desired energy amount to transfer, and then the block calculates how much you can actually send according to max energy extraction and receive rates of the block. After we find this out, we can use the send and extract blocks to transfer the energy. Note that you can specify from which side you draw or push energy. This is so that different block sites can have different functionality. For example, if you want to send energy from one block to the block below it, we need to draw energy from the current block on sides any direction or down, depending on whether the block limits energy output on some sides or not. To push it to the block below it on the top side, we use up as the direction. Now I'll create some textures using the integrated texture editor, namely the machine base, solar panel side and top, the fan exhaust, battery input and output indicators, as well as the energy meter texture. I'll import a quarter block model I created earlier and bind the solar panel textures to it in the resources tab and start with creating our first block. Starting with the solar panel, I choose the block model we imported earlier and select a texture for the main texture. In my case, I'll use the top solar panel texture. We also need to change the block's bounding box to be only a quarter a block thick. Note that only setting the bounding box won't make the block any smaller, hence the need for a custom model. On the next panel, I'll tweak some of the block settings, like the block sound to make it feel made out of stone, as well as set its tick rate to 1 on the next page. Now I don't want this block to store any energy, so I'll skip that. However, we do want this block to generate energy and output it at the bottom side, so I'll create a new procedure in the update tick trigger. In the procedure, I want to check three things before generating energy, so I'll add an if block with two nested ends with external inputs so the procedure looks clearer. First, I want to check whether this block can see the sky and if it's currently day in the provided world. We could also check if it's currently sunny, but for the sake of simplicity, we don't. Now, we also want to know whether the block below this one can receive energy from the top side. In the if's body, we send energy to the said block. Note that in this case, we don't need to test whether this block can output the said amount because it doesn't have energy storage, and the send procedure block respects the receiving block's maximum energy capacity, so the energy won't exceed the block's limits. Note that we now don't know how much energy we transferred, but that doesn't matter in this case. We can now save the procedure and the block. By the way, a sub to the channel would be amazing. Now let's add a fan block. The idea is that if this block has energy in it, it uses 50 energy per tick to push mobs and items in the direction it is facing. This will require energy storage and a lengthy procedure, but don't worry, I'll try to keep it as simple as possible. First, we create the block, set all of its textures to the machine base, except for the front one that is the fan gates. Don't forget to turn on the down, up, north, south, west, east from the player side block rotation. Much like for the solar panel, we tweak its step sound as well as the tick rate. Since this block will store some energy, we have to first enable tile entity and then on the energy and fluid storage tab, enable energy storage as well. I'll set its max capacity to 4000 and leave both max input and output rates to 200. On the triggers tab, we want to add a procedure to the update tick trigger. I'll provide the entire procedure template on the MCreator's website, the link for which is in the description. In it, we first check if the current block has any energy. In particular, we want it to have more than 50, since that will be its power consumption. In the body, we first consume that energy and then add another if with 5 else if blocks for every side of the block. For example, if the block is facing upwards, we check for any entities that are in a 6x6x6 cube, 3 blocks in front of it, and are of type entity living, which is for all the living entities. Now set the movement vector in the direction of the y-axis to something like 0.2 for the entity we checked for its existence before. We apply the same approach for the entity item entity types and repeat this process for all block sides. Now save the procedure as well as the block. Before we start testing this, I also want to add the energy meter to be able to measure the fan's energy amount. We start by creating the item, select the texture on the first step, move it to the tools tab on properties, and set its max stack size to 1. We'll use the when right clicked on block procedure trigger and create a fresh procedure for it. Add a send message block with show in action bar enabled. We replace the string block with create text width, add 3 more inputs to it so that we have 5. In the first input, get the energy of the clicked block on the clicked side. This is important because some modded blocks can have multiple energy storages for different sides. Add a slash in the second input, and in the third one, add a get energy capacity block in a similar fashion to the first one. Then add energy add string to the fourth one, and at the end, append the side we clicked on. Now we can save both mod elements and hit start to test this puppy out. If we put the solar panel on top of the fan block, we can see the energy level increase because it's currently daytime. If we set the time to nighttime and replace the fan with a fresh and empty one, we see no energy level increase. Furthermore, if we put entities in front of it, they don't get pushed. If we set the time to daytime again, the fan is being charged and the entities are getting pushed around again. Now for the last thing in this tutorial, I'd like to combine pretty much everything we learned about Forge Energy so far and use the knowledge in a battery block. Just like the last two blocks we created, we need to create a block. I want the top to be the input and all the other sides to be outputs, so I'll use the orange indicator on all sides but the top one, where I'll use the blue one. Adjust the same properties we did for the first two blocks and enable tile entity as well as energy storage. I'll set its capacity to 1 million and its max throughput to 10,000. Again, we'll be using the update tick procedure. We have to add an extraction procedure for each side of the block, but I'll only show you how to do one, and you can finish the procedure yourselves or just simply use the procedure template. Note that you have to add the variables before importing the procedure template to save yourselves from the hassle of replacing all custom variable blocks. Also make sure to name them exactly the same as in the tutorial to avoid any unnecessary complications. Now let's proceed with the procedure. First, I'll add 5 number variables, one for each output side of the block. Let's call them down, north, west, south and east. Then add an if statement and check if the block below this one can receive energy on the top, which means that we need to subtract one from the y coordinate and set the side to up. In case it can, we want to test whether we can send 10,000 energy down from this block and how much energy can be transferred. We save that number in the down variable and then test whether the block below this one can receive that energy on the top side, and again, save the new value in the variable. Now we just need to extract that amount of energy from the battery and send it to the block below to the upper side. Repeat the process for all the sides and you should be good to go. We can now test this out in Minecraft using everything we created in this tutorial. Note that because all sides of the blocks are inputs by default, if we place the batteries next to each other, they will also exchange energy with one another, so when one fills up, it will pass the energy to this closest neighboring one. This is normal and shouldn't affect their behavior a lot. We can also have a little fun and create a floating cushion for mobs using the new fans we created. Thanks for watching this tutorial. I'll link the mod page on MCreator's website in the description so that you can play around with everything we created in this tutorial without even needing to do anything. Videos like this take a lot of time to make, so a sub to the channel would be greatly appreciated. If you don't want to miss the latest MCreator related news and tutorials, turn on the notifications, like for more content like this, and comment with suggestions down below. Have a nice day and happy modding!